What is up, everyone? Get hyped. Today is the day. Nintendo Direct E3 2021. Bringing it to you live on the Twitch channel. Kyle the Pug, TTV. Jake, I see you, man. What is going on? How is everybody doing? Keep all the expectations low, but keep the hypes up high. So hype responsibly, though, everybody. So what is up, Jake? I see you, man. How you doing? So thank God I'm not alone here for this reaction, because I'm here with a friend. He's on his phone at work, though, so it might be a little bit delayed, but Sean's here with us. So Sean, what's up, man? How are you doing? How hyped are you right now? If you can still hear me,
I'm
that
good,
is. Yeah, I was going to say, there's a little delay, but we're ready to go. I'm excited, but I'm at the same token, I'm keeping my expectations low. So Jake, I see you, man. You're ready to go. Everybody's ready to go here. We only got like a few minutes before it starts here. So are you guys looking for anything in particular? Like, what are your hopes? What are your expectations here? Even though I did say to keep the expectations low, but we're going to kind of break a little bit of the rules here a little bit. But what's your guys' dream prediction? I want to know. You can let me know in the chat. Sean, you can let me know also. I'm hyped. Let's go. Throw out those predictions.
Yeah, I mean, ideally, I'd like to, obviously, Breath of the Wild 2 is the big name on everyone's lips, obviously. It's been a while since we heard anything. I'd love to see more Metroid Prime 3 since they reset development a few years ago. And,
ooh, you mean the fourth one, not 3.
I wouldn't mind seeing Bayonetta 3.
Jake said he is... It's okay. Yeah, I mean, it's... I would have bad memories of that, too. Game Master said he's watching this and The Shack. Nice. That's awesome. You got two windows open. That's right. Rebecca is reacting on with Nintendo Shack with Donnie and Garrett. Definitely go check them out. Twitch.tv/PHBG. A little shout out to them in plug-in.
Time to split.
Thank you for the 5 bits, Game Master. You're awesome, dude. And Jake Lester says the HD collection of Zelda, Twilight Princess, and Wind Waker. That's another pretty good solid prediction, too. That would be a nice little... let's just say a nice little 35th collector's edition, as you can say. But I think the big prize here is the Breath of the Wild 2 title, which is everybody's going for. At least to me. But, oh man. Oh, the excitement's filling up here. We got like a couple of minutes left to go. Oh my god, how hyped are you guys on a scale of like 1 to 10 right now? With 10 being the highest. I mean, it's okay to be in the middle, though, because I know you're trying to keep the expectations low, but how hyped are you guys right now on the scale 1 to 10? Oh, man. Yo, Jake with the 100 bits. Thank you so much, dude. Thank you, man. You're awesome. You got just a complete 10. That is just all the way up. Hey, we never know. We might see something Metroid-related, so you never know. We'll see. And I moved the Pug one, and I think I mentioned this before, I moved the Pug one to 90 bits, where he's diving underwater and he had the smooth Magruva. You love to be disappointed, exactly. I was going to check and see if, okay, I think Sean's still in the chat? Let me see.
I'm still here, yeah.
Yeah, okay, I was just making sure, yeah, because I know you've been
doing less noisy spot.
Yo, there's the 90 biddies. Thank you, Jake. You're awesome, dude. If you guys haven't checked out Jake Luster, go check him out. He streams almost every single day, but he's, yo, Fanta Dave, what's up, man? How you doing? Yeah, definitely go check out Jake Luster, guys. Awesome, dude. Awesome. Loves Zelda games like I do. And just an all-around cool dude. So get hyped, everybody. This is it. This is the day. This is the day where dreams are achieved and dreams get shot down, just like that. Oh my goodness. So
just like real life.
Exactly, just like real life. You heard it first here. Well, actually didn't really hear it first. I think it's just like very, very common. Oh my god. Okay, so let me just check if I'm surrounding myself by cool people, and you, the Pug Man, are the cool. You know, you're the coolest. You're the coolest, Jake. You're the coolest, dude. I am nowhere to being cool. I'm just a guy that calls myself Pug in live streams. Like, Come on now. I mean, hey, if you guys call me Pugman, call me Pug, call me whatever you want, you know. That's fine. I'm cool with that. Wait, did it actually start, or am I, is it just, like, on the, hold on. It's 9 o'clock, so let me...
BSRB just started.
Oh, did it actually just start? Okay, hold on, I'm about to refresh here. Okay, yeah, perfect. It just started. Awesome. Okay, so I had to switch it here. All right, here we go. This is it. This is it. Oh, so they're dropping just like this. Just like this. No shadow drop, no nothing. It is starting.
Hello, everyone. I'm Shinya Takahashi, and I'll be your guide for today's Nintendo Direct.
Ooh.
Hello, I'm Yoshiaki Koizumi, and I'll be your guide as well.
Got a double guide.
The Nintendo Switch system is now in its fifth year, and many people around the world are...
Fifth year, that's insane.
Nintendo Switch is being enjoyed by a wide range of players spanning all ages.
Yep, it is.
And all levels of gaming experience. Thank you all very much. We've been able to offer a wide variety of games on the system.
He said, that's the show. Good night, everybody. Just imagine if they edited it like that.
I hope that each of you watching this Nintendo Direct will be able to find a game that suits your personal tastes.
Ooh.
Today, we have news on upcoming Nintendo Switch games, and we'll be focusing on a selection of games releasing this year. We hope you enjoy it.
Oh, here comes the annual finger snap.
Take a look at this video.
Oh, double snap. Kind of delayed there. Not actual. Ooh, this looks a little too good to be on the Switch. Oh shit! It's Ganondorf. What is this? Oh my goodness. Did they actually show it?
Well, we got a chicken rep in here, huh?
Oh! What? It's Tekken. A Tekken fighter's in Smash. I've seen this character. They added Tekken to... Oh my god. Yo, that's actually cool. He just dumps the bot. That is so dark and gruesome. Oh. Oh my god. This is actually awesome. Yeah, I did. I'll admit, I actually did get it a little bit trolled, to be honest. Everybody thought, like, oh, Ganondorf's being tossed down in the pit, though, but... That's... Kazuya. Yeah, Kazuya from Tekken. That's cool. That's actually... I knew they were going to shadow drop a DLC. Oh, there's Kirby. Kirby. Aw. That poor Kirby. Oh, he just flies up. He just floats up. He's like, oh, where did he go? Somebody didn't realize Kirby could do that.
Hello, I'm Masahiro Sakurai from Sora Limited and the director of the Super Smash Bros. Ultimate game. Kazuya Mishima from the fighting game series Tekken will join the battle. Surprise!
Ooh.
I'll go over the details at a later date, so please sit tight.
It'll probably be like
today,
a week later.
We prepared a short video to showcase Kazuya's moves in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Please take a look.
Oh, so they're actually showing... Okay, so it's just like the alpha. Yo, Lucy, what's up? How are you doing? He looks like he could be a hard character to use, though, just like Ryu is. Like, I'm not even kidding.
Yeah, it looks a little more technical.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, kind of like some Street Fighter Tekken-like stuff. Stalker starts in an hour, but you're good to go until then. Well, you have the Nintendo Direct to watch until that starts, Lucy. So you're pretty much all set. You're in the right place.
This feels like Tekken. No, it's Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. I'll talk about the fighter more.
I bet you Sakurai's played a lot of Tekken, though.
We still have to record it first, actually.
Oh,
the air date is shown below.
Yep, I figured it was going to be a week later, June 28th.
Thank you, Mr. Sakurai. New fighter Kazuya will join the fight in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate.
In the right place.
Yeah, it's always great that there's not much of a wait for these characters.
Yeah. And then usually after the Sakurai presentation, they usually drop it like a day or two later. Maybe like a week at max. I have Smash, but I don't really play it as much.
I barely touch it, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think I only played like the first 2 hours of Smash and that's it. Just to be honest.
Ooh. Yeah, it was definitely a game I enjoyed more as a kid with like my brothers at home. Like online just doesn't have the same feeling to it for me.
Oh, Life is Strange?
It's a great party game for when I have
guests. Oh my goodness, they have Life is Strange coming to the Switch. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, I've heard good things about that. I haven't gotten to try it yet.
Oh, the remastered and True Colors coming to the Switch. Oh my goodness. Life is Strange finally coming to the Switch. I wonder how that's gonna run though on the Switch. True Colors. And the remastered edition too. The big one tonight is going to be tonight's Germany versus France. Ooh,
Life is
Strange, that is pretty
True
big.
Colors launches on Nintendo Switch September 10th.
September 10th.
Life is Strange Remastered Collection comes to Nintendo Switch later this year.
Yo, I'm happy that is coming to the Switch.
On the Nintendo Switch system.
I know a couple people that want that on the Switch.
You
Guardians of the Galaxy.
A legendary band of heroes for hire.
I saw this through the Square Enix.
Jump on a wild ride.
The Square Enix presentation.
Overwhelm opponents with Star-Lord's daring combat style and encounter iconic and original Marvel characters. You'll call the shots for the unpredictable.
This isn't a day one purchase, but I think I'll get it if it's like on sale. Yeah, Guardians of the Galaxy. Yeah, that exactly, Jake.
Blasts onto Nintendo Switch October 26th. Worms everywhere.
Worms rumble.
In this real-time arena-based shooter, you'll squish your invertebrate opponents in 32-player cross-platform combat.
The last time I even saw Worms was Achievement Hunter. Rooster Teeth was doing a little Let's Play of it every Wednesday. That's pretty big, Pug. Life is Strange. It is. 100% that's big. It was, like, overdue to be on the Switch a long time ago. And I'm surprised it was, like, they announced it really, really late.
The fantastical realm of Orcanon awaits. As you explore this fully hand-painted world, you'll customize a team of demigods and unleash devastating attacks and captivating turn-based combat.
RPG-like stuff.
Astria Ascending launches on Nintendo Switch September 30th. Return to the funny, charming, and quirky world of Two Point County. In the wholesome management sim Two Point Campus, you'll build and run your very own university the way you want it.
The Sims College University? Question mark? I don't know, that's the first thing that came into my mind.
Enrollment for Two Point Campus starts on Nintendo Switch next year.
Next year on the Switch.
A beloved series rolls into its
20th anniversary.
A monkey ball.
Uh-huh. Dun-dun. Yep.
Still remember playing the first two on Cube.
Ooh, Monkey Ball. 20th anniversary of Monkey Ball. I never played this personally, but I know a lot of people that did play this. Wah!
Yeah, I feel like they got worse after the GameCube.
Mm-hmm. I was gonna say, the courses actually look really fun. Like the obstacles. Ooh. Get to play baseball, soccer. Got some monkey ball sports. Yeah, sign me up for that.
Go bananas when Super Monkey October 5th. Banana Mania rolls onto Nintendo Switch October 5th.
October 5th.
It's a blast from parties past.
Oh, it's Mario Party.
Ready
yep.
for another round of Mario Party Mayhem?
Yep.
Of course you are.
If you had told me I would have known more about Monkey Ball's anniversary before Zelda, I would have called you a liar, right? Oh, Mario Party 1 Remastered? Oh, that actually looks dope.
This board is packed with zany events guaranteed to keep you on your toes. And when we say
oh,
zany,
that looks sick. They remastered Mario past Mario Party games. That's so cool. Facelift 2. Oh my god.
In hilarious over the top mini
facelift. Look away. Oh my god. This is a
with 100 mini games from the Mario Party series.
This brings back memories. That's awesome.
This All-Star Fun Fest. Here's a little party favor. All game modes work with online play.
Wow, looks like they actually incorporated the elements people said were missing from the last one.
Mm-hmm. You're buying. Save your progress mid-game.
Save your progress mid-game. Grab a snack, then resume the festivities. Stickers are also available to community.
Ooh, I hear the Spaceland music too.
It's time to party in
Mario Party Superstars. Ooh. On the Nintendo Switch system. I might get this too.
Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop.
I might get this later on.
What did you think?
Please. Nintendo knows the way through my wallet and my heart.
Currently, we're working hard.
That's the God's truth.
Metroid Prime series.
Wait.
Metroid Prime 4, which we previously announced. But today, we'd like to introduce another new entry in the Metroid franchise.
Metroid. Oh no. Is it 2D? It's a new entry to Metroid. Oh my god. Oh my goodness. Metroid 5? Wait, what is this? Oh my god, this looks pretty. This is definitely 2D. This has to be. This is 2D. Oh my god, this looks so cool!
Oh man, I am clearly sold on this.
Oh yeah.
I'm gonna get a new 2D.
Yeah. 100%. Oh, this looks amazing! Oh, Elias is happy somewhere.
Wow. So the biggest, wow, they brought back the name Dread. That's, holy cow.
Metroid Dread.
Dread has been rumored since Prime 3 on the Wii.
Yeah, I'm surprised they released it so late. Oh, this. Oh, this looks. Even though it's a side scroller, yeah, I agree, Jake. 100%. This looks so clean. It's about time something Metroid got released. Ooh, Samus climbing like that. That's so cool. Oh my god.
Oh man, I can't wait. That looks phenomenal.
Yeah, I agree. See it on the treehouse.
Sweet.
On the treehouse. We got treehouse gameplay. Oh my god, 10-8. That's another birthday gift that I'm getting for myself.
That was the trailer for the
That was. Are you guys excited for that? You got to know if you're excited. I know everybody's excited.
Metroid Dread game. As the name Dread implies, This is a Metroid game with a new feel, showcasing a variety of threats that Samus will encounter. It's scheduled to be released on October 8th, so it won't be too long until launch. On that same day,
Amiibos!
Amiibo figures for Samus and the Emmy, the robot seen in the video.
Oh, they got the Amiibos. I knew they were gonna have Amiibos. That's awesome. You know what? That's awesome. I applaud that.
Get ready to get down.
Oh no. You're buying it. I am so buying that. 100%. Yeah, definitely copyright music, but eh. Doesn't matter.
Floor in Just Dance 2022.
I'm not a good dancer, so this isn't for me. This is not for me.
Yeah, I'm gonna pass too.
Yeah, that's a pass.
Speeding onto Nintendo Switch. Blast your way through nearly 30 over-the-top tracks. Up to 4 players can race together, so pick your favorite vehicle and hit the road. Cruisin' Blast launches as a console exclusive on Nintendo Switch this
fall. Cruisin' Blast. Kind of reminds me of that Oral Arcade from back in the day that I used to play. Can't think of the name of it, though.
Relive the story of Goku.
You've been known to cut some rug, but that's way too much exercise in video games for your liking, right?
Protect the Earth.
Exactly. I absolutely agree, 100%.
Frieza, take a stand against the evil Emperor. Cell. Battle the androids in a fight to the death. Majin Buu, an epic showdown with the most fearsome foe. Along with the main story, you can explore the vast world of Dragon Ball Z.
Dragon Ball Z.
Help out the locals, or collect ingredients for delicious meals.
You can that's a big fish. Too.
There are lots of things to keep you busy. The boss battle episodes, A New Power Awakens, parts 1 and 2 is also included. Dragon Ball Z Kakarot, plus A New Power Awakens set, punches its way onto Nintendo Switch September 24th.
Oh, Mario Golf.
Club and get ready to tee off.
Oh.
The Mario Golf Super Rush game.
Yeah, he knew they were going to have a Super Rush info.
Here's a quick glimpse into each of the modes. Standard Golf. Take your time to read the wind and
terrain. Yeah, you already know. You already know I'm getting this.
Different types of shots, aim for under par.
Nice birdie.
Yeah.
Speed golf.
Ooh.
Smack your ball.
A lot of non-golfers gonna be playing speed golf.
Ball in the hole. Outpace your rivals with special dashes and special shots.
Oh, the Pauline's microphone.
Battle
then
golf.
He got battle golf.
Duke it out over 9 flag-marked holes in an obstacle-filled arena.
A lot of this actually looks amazing.
Golf adventure.
They got like everything combined into I was gonna say they got everything like you want in a Mario golf game.
And here's some news.
Ooh, new Dog City!
Future release, including additional courses and playable characters.
Yeah, I could tell that was some Mario Odyssey stuff right there.
And get ready to ace those shots. In Mario Golf Super Rush, swinging onto the Nintendo Switch system June.
That's 10 more days.
Pre-orders are available now.
And Treehouse. We also on Treehouse, so it's along with Metroid.
Ready for the ride of a lifetime?
Okay, Monster Hunt. Yeah, that was announced during the Cap. I think they were in the Capcom thing too, but I think this got leaked also.
As a rider in this RPG adventure, you'll explore diverse landscapes by riding your Monstie, a monster companion. Gather materials such as honey and ore, then use them to craft items for your journey. But beware of the many monsters roaming about. Some are docile, but others may suddenly ambush you.
Ugh, out of nowhere.
To fight,
just like
you'll team up with your Monstie.
Yeah, this is right up Sean's alley right here.
In turn-based battles.
But on that Monster Hunter grind.
You'll be rewarded with their materials, which can be forged into new weapons and armor. Hey, is that an egg? you might be able to hatch a new monster.
Is that an egg?
Incredibly,
I think it is an egg.
Powerful monsties can also hatch from rare eggs. Need more traveling buddies? Join
yeah, I haven't played the story games at all. I've stuck to the mainline ones.
Mm-hmm. Buckle up, Ryder. It's going to be a real monster of an adventure. Monster Hunter
on
Stories
July 9th.
Wings of Ruin soars onto Nintendo.
Another
Switch
Treehouse.
July 9th.
Another Treehouse exclusive.
You can play the free demo on June 25th and
Ooh.
Carry over your save data to the full game.
I might check out the demo. Maybe. Who knows?
Here's a new game from the head of a certain company.
Oh, wait. It looked like WarioWare.
Did you miss me?
Hey, it's WarioWare.
Who am I? It's a me.
Finally, yeah.
Yes, finally, WarioWare. Wow!
New game from my company. Check it out.
Oh my god, this was about time.
Time to do this.
I need to play. WarioWare looks so fun. Like, I definitely do need to play. Yeah, WarioWare!
They have wonderful new talents. Throw that stick thing. Not the bad. Use the spinny, whatchamacallit. Ha! Nailed it! Same micro game, different abilities. Wah, I almost forgot some big news. Two people at the same time.
Co-op. Nice. Got the co-op pipes.
Eh? Not nice. All right, you. Yes, you, the one watching this. Better get ready for some micro game mayhem.
WarioWare, get it together. September 10th.
Exclusively on the Nintendo Switch.
Another Treehouse exclusive. There's a lot of Treehouse exclusives.
On Nintendo eShop.
What you just saw was the trailer for WarioWare. Get it together.
Ooh.
In the latest
installment, I was gonna say that actually this looks cool.
Games that let you control Wario and his friends. There is also a two-player.
I love the Super Mario Land throwback there.
Expands the gameplay. It's releasing in the near future, so stay tuned. Next, please take a look at this.
Oh, we got another one. I like the snaps a little.
I think it's a Shin Megami Tensei 5.
Yeah.
As a high school student living in Tokyo.
Yeah, this is. I know somebody that would like this game real well.
But that reality is upended.
I'm not really into these sort of games, but I know a lot of people are hyped for it. Like, where am I?
A post-apocalyptic world where angels and
I enjoyed the fourth one on the 3DS. I never finished it though.
Mm. It's not like a game I'd get into, like for real. But hey, if people like it, you know, that's their deal. You know, you enjoy what you like.
What lies ahead in this alternate realm?
Yep.
Number 5.
The world is now transformed into a sprawling, demon-infested wasteland. Though friendly demons do exist here, many are hostile.
Friendly
will
demons
attempt to destroy you. Harness your newfound powers to fight demons using a command-based system. Finding their weak point is key. By targeting it, the number of consecutive actions you can perform.
I wish I could stay a little longer. I have to be going in about 2 or 3 minutes, unfortunately.
Oh, that's okay. No worries.
Formidable.
Yeah, I appreciate you.
I get an hour, and I can't believe it's almost up already.
Right? Time flies when you're watching Nintendo-related stuff, I can tell you that much.
Yeah, no kidding.
Oh, my goodness.
If a negotiation is
successful, yeah, we're only, like, halfway through it.
Will become a powerful ally.
Like, at least halfway through.
In some cases, by rejecting a demon's request, they may feel motivated.
But yeah, if you have to go, man, just don't hesitate to let me know, and I'll give you a nice little shout out. Luminaire23 on Twitter.
Stronger.
Go check him out. Go follow him.
By fusing demon allies, another demon can be created. The newly fused demon's innate abilities will vary, granting you a powerful ally.
customized to your needs. It looks like Jebel from Deltarune a little bit.
Yeah.
Challenge the many demons roaming this post-apocalyptic world by harnessing the power of your own. What destiny will you choose?
November 12th. Also on Treehouse.
Nintendo Switch, November 12th. Pre-orders for the physical version begin June 21st.
Oh, so that's 6 days from now.
That was the latest trailer for Shin Megami Tensei V from Atlus. This is the newest game in the series. Please look forward to future updates.
Oh, future updates incoming.
Let's see a few more Nintendo Switch headlines.
I was gonna say the snapping's a little, like I said, the sound's delayed. Why does that bear look so demonic? I wouldn't want to meet that in a dark alley. I want to celebrate 35 years. Keep your fingers and toes crossed, Jake. Self-proclaimed school headmaster has trapped you and other high school students in a game of literal life and death. Unfortunately, the only way out of the school and this lethal game is to betray the other students. Oh, so this is like, so this is like Among Us, but anime style. A class trial will take place to reveal the culprit. You're the culprit, aren't you, Mew? I'm telling you, I had no idea. They probably moved the body. This is literally Among Us anime. That's all it is. Find the guilty party. Sneak attack.
Arokai.
Are you okay? Are you okay? No, I'm not okay.
Plus, the board game from Danganronpa V3 Killing Harmony has been expanded into a standalone game. Danganronpa S.
Alright, Kyle, I'll talk to you later. I'm not sure if that went through or not.
Alright, man, take her easy. Check out Luminaire23 on Twitter. Go check him out. He is awesome.
Take care.
Yeah, thanks for being on. Thanks for reacting with me.
Absolutely.
You go have a good day at work.
Launches as a physical exclusive on Nintendo
Switch. Alrighty.
All four games will also be individually available.
Like I said, this just was just so Among Us like vibes with that. Oh, is this Fatal Frame? Yeah, it is. Okay, that's what I thought it was. Yeah, Fatal Frame.
In this horror adventure game, you'll uncover the mysteries surrounding the ethereal but deadly Mount Hikami, believed to be at the center of many disappearances. Ghosts frequent this mount.
Yeah, I know somebody that plays this game.
Is a camera that can repel and cast the mount. Face your fears as you explore a variety of unsettling locations. This spine-chilling story features various protagonists, letting you experience the game from different perspectives. New costumes and photo modes are included in this version. Can you investigate Mount Hikami and stay alive? Fatal Frame, Maiden of Black Water, creeps onto Nintendo Switch this year.
Later this year, we don't know when, though.
These games and DLC are coming soon, some even today.
Oh, DLC. What kind of DLC we got? Oh, Doom Eternal.
Raise hell in the first campaign expansion for Doom Eternal, The Ancient Gods Part 1. Deeper and more challenging combat awaits as you eliminate hell's newest threats in demon-infested ruins and rain-swept terrain.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't think I would get into this. I know there's a lot of people that do, though.
Cosmos is in your hands. Get slaying when this campaign expansion launches on Nintendo Switch later today.
Later today. Oh, Tony Hawk.
Get ramped up for two iconic.
It's been a long time since I played Tony Hawk. HD.
Skate to era-defining jams as the legendary Tony Hawk and a roster of new and returning pros. Take your sessions on the go with all.
I need to play as Iron Man, though.
And compete locally or online to show off your tricks against other skaters. Drop in to Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 1 and 2, launching on Nintendo Switch June 25th.
Aw, they didn't show Iron Man. That's okay. Maybe next time. You stream Tony Hawk Underground every now and then? Yeah, it actually does look fun.
And only can stop her. The Strange Brigade. In this thrilling adventure, you'll blast through an army of mummified monstrosities while solving puzzles in booby-trapped dungeons. Go it alone or team up with other daring adventurers in local wireless co-op and online play. Expect the unexpected when Strange Brigade launches on Nintendo Switch later today.
That's okay. Oh, Mario Rabbids, they showed that on Ubisoft. They showed this on the Ubisoft trailer.
Mario and his friends will team up with the Rabbids once again to restore order to the galaxy.
This one's pretty hype. I like this. Mysterious new evil from even though the Luma Rabbid kind of looks a little creepy.
Rabbid Rosalina joins them. Wait, is she bored already? Explore planets filled with quirky residents and even quirkier secrets. And in this fresh take on the tactical...
This looks really clean, though.
Our heroes can run freely around the battlefield, creating new strategic and chaotic possibilities. So aim for victory with a little help from your friends.
Wait, who's that?
Oh, somebody had the hearts. Like,
This is gonna be one heck of a galactic adventure. Mario plus Rabbids Sparks of Hope launches into space or onto Nintendo Switch next year.
Space and Nintendo Switch, that's fine. Orange Star is under attack. Oh. Wait, is this, this, I was gonna say, this looks familiar. I was about to say Advance Wars. Never really played this, though. Reimagined and rebuilt. See why this game was popular back in the day.
Stories, memorable characters, and vibrant gameplay are in store as you lead the commanding officers to victory. Play the first two Advance Wars campaigns in Advance Wars 1 plus 2
Reimagine.
Marching on to Nintendo Switch this holiday. Pre-orders
on Treehouse.
On Nintendo eShop.
I think that was 5.
All right. This next segment will be our last announcement of the day.
Oh boy, last announcement. Last announcement, what is it? Oh, the Age of Calamity DLC. Oh, you get to... Okay. What is this? What are these weapons? I mean, this looks cool. I know this is the expansion pass. Oh, she's riding the horse. Pulse of the Ancients. So that's in 3 days. I don't know if I would want to, that's not really a day one, though.
This one came to me at 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning one morning. I'm like,
hello there. I'm Eiji Aonuma, producer of the Legend of Zelda series. What you've just seen is a trailer for the first wave of DLC for the Hyrule Warriors Age.
It looks pretty cool. I mean, I'll get it eventually.
It will follow Link and his allies through more battles that took place 100 years prior to the events.
Oh, we already know that.
Breath of the Wild.
We already knew that.
I hope you'll look forward to it. I have a few more things to share with you all today.
Oh boy.
We'll begin with the Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword HD game, which launches next month. You'll immerse yourself in the role of Link by using 2 Joy-Con controllers for intuitive motion controls. Or by playing in handheld mode, wielding the sword via flicking the stick and button-only controls.
Oh, so they'll,
this game depicts the oldest era in the Legend of Zelda series.
I was gonna say, they have, like, certain options you can do.
What is the origin of the Master Sword? Why did a woman named Zelda become the legend for future generations?
Mm-hmm.
These will all be unraveled in this game. We hope you're looking forward.
Yeah, exactly
to
1 month.
Skyward Sword.
1 month from now. Mm-hmm.
Next up.
What's that?
Here's a little something you might like.
This oh,
is a
shit.
Game & Watch system that lets you play three games in the Legend of Zelda series.
Oh, a little
this
Game
year,
& Watch.
The original Legend of Zelda game reaches its 35th anniversary. While we don't have any campaigns or other Nintendo Switch games planned, we've been working on this Game & Watch system.
Oh, that's actually, that looks nice.
Occasion and reflect fondly on the earliest days of The Legend of Zelda.
Oh, that actually looks
it
cool.
Come with the first game in the series, The Legend of Zelda.
Oh, and then Legend of Link, or Adventure of Link.
And the Game Boy version of The Legend of Zelda, Link's
Awakening.
Oh,
that's cool.
As a special version of the Game & Watch title, Vermin.
Oh, I saw that. I remember playing Vermin.
So that's four games on.
That's actually cool, like Game & Watch.
Legend of Zelda games to the pick up and play game.
That's actually cool. I remember playing Vermin on my old Game Boy back in the day.
Regarding the watch functionality for the Game & Watch system, we've added a playable clock based on The Legend of Zelda.
Oh, that's sick.
And an interactive timer themed after Zelda.
That's actually, it's like Mario, but it's Zelda.
You can play with both of them by taking control of Link. We hope you'll enjoy playing this Game & Watch system.
Oh, November 12th.
Wherever you'd like.
They know the way to my bank account.
All right, here's the last thing we have to show you. This is the sequel to The Legend of Zelda.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
Years have passed since we first.
It's finally time. They're doing it. They're doing it.
However,
they're doing it.
Has been steadily progressing. For today, we've prepared some new footage to show a bit more of the
game. Oh, new footage, my boys. Here we go. Oh my goodness. Oh my god, this looks. Oh my god, this looks so sick. Oh my, what? Oh my god. Oh my dear lord, what is this? Combined enemies? Oh my god. Oh my goodness, this is nuts. You knew this was coming eventually. Dude, look at the background, it's so cool! 2022! But there's no titles yet. There's no title.
So, what did you think? This time around, the setting for the adventure has been expanded to include the skies above Hyrule.
Ooh, the skies.
I'd like to ask you to wait a bit longer.
PugChamp.
For a 2022 release, so I hope you'll look forward.
We don't want to still have a title though. But that's okay. We still got more info on it.
How was that? That's all for this Nintendo Direct. We are diligently continuing development on a number of other games.
Oh my god.
I hope you'll continue looking forward to what's in store.
Dude, that was hype. You knew Breath of the Wild 2 was coming. So yeah, no Kirby game, no Donkey Kong game. But that was it. I mean, they're going to show the treehouse here in a little bit. So they'll show some games here. What'd you guys think? I think it was solid.
Hi everyone, I'm Doug Bowser.
Oh, Doug Bowser.
And I'm here with Nate Bildorf, who leads our Treehouse team. As you know, at Nintendo, we're all about creating experiences that deliver surprises and smiles. And I have to say, I found myself...
You were hoping for the HD collection with the Breath of the Wild trailer. Dude, it was. It was actually pretty damn awesome.
...with everyone in the weeks and months ahead. Nate, that last clip was incredible. So many questions. Where do we start? What did you think?
Oh, well, Doug, they had me at the first mysterious red tendril. You know what a massive Zelda fan I am. And I'm frankly just looking forward to seeing all the games that are in the pipeline just over the next couple months for Nintendo Switch. We've got Mario Party Superstars, WarioWare Get It Together.
Dude, this was a good Direct. Like, this was a very solid Direct.
Zelda Skyward Sword HD, Mario Golf
Super. Definitely give it like a 9 out of 10, 100%.
Boot Camp, and of course, Metroid Dread. I am just not going to be getting any work done, and you should know.
Well, that's okay. I think I may be in the same camp. And Mario Golf Super Rush launches in just a few weeks on June the 25th. By the way, Nate, do you know why Luigi brings two pairs of pants to the golf course with him?
You're going to go process this? Yeah, definitely go process this now.
In case he gets a hole in one. But seriously, everyone, this game is just packed with content. You can play in standard golf mode, but then there's also speed golf, battle golf, the golf adventure mode, and the option to play with buttons or motion controls. And you can play with up to four people locally or online. I can say this one is definitely going to be taking up the majority of my summer gaming time.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you and me both. And there's plenty more to come.
I think everybody, Doug, everybody, dude.
Show is just getting started. Next up, we, have Nintendo Treehouse Live, and we'll be kicking off our first segment with a very special guest, Yoshio Sakamoto, who is the producer of Metroid Dread.
Oh, dude, this is going to be exciting. I want to see some of this.
But the first 2D, new 2D Metroid game in nearly two decades.
Two decades? That's a long time.
I'm so looking forward to this. And we do have our Treehouse team on deck for a gameplay deep dive into Metroid Dread, WarioWare Get It Together, and more games in a mix of both live and pre-recorded segments today. And I'd just like to say as we close how deeply grateful we are to everyone watching today. Thank you for sharing this time with us, and we hope you enjoy it.
Yep. Thanks again, everyone. We can't wait to hear what you think.
Oh, my goodness.
I'll turn it over to Sakamoto-san and the Treehouse team.
I do want to see some of this. I wonder what timeline is going to be taking place in with Dread. Wonder if it's set like after Fusion or something. Development history. So we might about to find out here.
メトロイドドレッドをやっと発表できました。1986年のメトロイドから始まって、メトロイド2、スーパーメトロイド、メトロイドフュージョンと続いてきたシリーズの19年ぶりの最新作、そして最新エピソードになります。 メトロイドシリーズはサムス・アランと女性版を描いたゲームです。タイトルのメトロイドっていうのは生物兵器として軍事利用できる浮遊生命体の名前で、いろんなトラブルのきっかけになってきました。シリーズではそのメトロイドと主人公サムスとの奇妙な関係性を綴ってきましたが、今回はそのストーリーの一区切りとなるエピソード。シリーズファンには
So it does take place after Fusion. Maybe. Dude, I like the new Various suit. That actually looks awesome. All these robots. 15 years ago, now up on the Switch. It's kind of understandable to have him seize the project back then, not to have enough, you know.
マーキュリースティームエンターテインメントのすごく優秀なチームだったんです。技術力は高いしセンスもいいし、なんといってもメトロイドというゲームの理解が半端なかったんですね。この最高のパートナーと組んだらメトロイドドレッドは必ず完成すると確信しました。そして15年前に思い描いた以上のメトロイドドレッドがこうやって完成しました。
今回登場するエミーを一言で言うとめっちゃ恐ろしい敵ですね。実は銀河連邦所有の調査ロボット。いや、I was gonna say I think this is the point where the Galactic Federation turned on her. Now the robots are looking. Yeah, I'm hyped about this game. This looks so cool.
サムスは厳しいですね。サムスはそんな恐怖と戦いながらミッションを遂行しなければならないんですね。今回のサムスは一段と大変ですね。サムスにとってものすごく不利な状況なんですが、検知範囲内であっても音を立てなければエミは気づきません。Oh,
so it relies on sound. That's pretty unique though. It's like a if it detects sound, it's going to hear you. Oh, that's actually so sweet. So cool.
ちゃったんじゃないかなと思われたかもしれません。でもそこはご安心ください。従来通りのゲーム性に磨きをかけて、アクションや探索要素の強化や工夫はバッチリです。サムスリターンズのアクションを洗練させて、フリーエイムやメレーカウンターなどを活用しました。Melee counters,
ooh, that was clean. You could parry people and enemies. Ooh, you can actually slide under this shit. That's awesome. Just be like, whoosh, like Batman sliding. That's awesome.
メトロイドは探索要素について簡単に触れておきますね。メトロイドは探索型のアクションゲームです。パワーアップアビリティを使ってサムスの行動を増やす。それらのアクションでサムスの行動範囲が広がっていくという仕組みです。
A spider magnet. Ooh, that's how. Okay, so that's how you kind of like jump up. I'll say the jumping animation, the movements. I was just gonna say it looks very, very clean. Dan, take it away. Treehouse Live.
Welcome to Nintendo Treehouse Live. I am super excited about this next segment where we're going to delve into an early work in progress version of Metroid Dread.
Yeah, I got to see what everybody's saying. So
I think get to a little bit of the way the game develops this suspense and tension that gives the game its title. So I'm joined by Audrey and Teresa from Nintendo Treehouse, and Teresa's going to take us into the depth of Planet ZDR.
Yeah, all right. So let's take a deep dive into the very beginning of the game. So we're going to back.
Oh, so, okay, so it just kind of takes you into that.
Samus is free movement here. So, like, I just spent a little few missiles, so I'm going to use this interactive here to replenish. But one of the things I want to show here is free aim, which for those that have played Metroid Samus Returns.
Yeah, I got some stuff to tweet out here, so give me a second.
See a lot of the area around as you use it. Also has this little tracking system that when it's
a tracking system,
it'll make that sound.
I want to take a moment to say that, as Nate and Sakamoto-san already mentioned, this is the first new 2D Metroid game in 19 years.
That's
almost two decades. I don't know.
Yeah, I was gonna say that's a long time.
It's a lot of years. We've been waiting for this for a long time, so we're really excited to be finally showing this to everyone.
Here's another returning move from Metroid: Samus Returns, which is the melee counter. One of my favorite features. And then a new one is, or the development of the melee counter. I'll let that guy move a little bit back. Come back. The melee dash.
Yeah, the melee
really
dash.
Because it doesn't break momentum. I can immediately do a counter and immediate damage to an enemy.
Yeah, something this game does really well is improve upon the improvements from Metroid: Samus Returns. So like you mentioned, we had free aim and the melee counter in that game. And here we have the running free aim, which gives you even more freedom, and the dash melee. So instead of having to stand still.
Yeah, if I'm quiet, that means I'm just looking some stuff up here to tweet out.
Go get him, which really has great movement to this game.
Yeah, I love that. Like, Samus moves so well, and it's just all that freedom. It's just, this is probably the smoothest I've been able to control Samus in a really long time.
Absolutely, and you've opened up the map screen here, something that Metroid fans know to love and adore.
Yeah.
The map system is just as important.
Let me turn this down
ever,
here. So
it really shows you the classic Metroid gameplay progression, which is back in full force in this game, where you look at your map, you identify areas that you haven't been to yet or aren't able to access yet, you try and find another way through, find a new ability, push your way forward, fill in the map, lather, rinse, repeat. So that's back and better than ever, in my opinion.
Yeah,
it's back and better than ever.
This area here is blinking white because there's something here that I haven't discovered yet. So I can use markers to kind of pinpoint it, just in case I don't have an ability, and I have to backtrack here once I'm able to explore it.
Yeah, don't sleep on those markers. Those can be really important in this labyrinthine world.
Sure. But this is curious.
It is really a part of the charm of Metroid, though.
Missile tank.
This,
you get two missile tanks.
Sense of purpose in your backtracking paired with pushing forward.
Yeah, another thing I want to pinpoint is the amount of work the dev team put in Samus's animations. Like, just her animation of gripping the walls when she can't move, or like holding onto the ledge. It's just so
yeah.
Yeah, it does have a lot of Samus Returns vibes to it too, from the 3DS.
That seamless transition to these sort of story scenes is great.
Little moments like this, when you're in helmet view for a moment, really add to the isolation and the tone of this game.
Yeah, no, this game is a sequel to Metroid Fusion, but you can see that her.
Yeah, I was figured as much.
So, that'll be a.
I figured it was gonna be after Fusion here.
These are the Emmy that Sakamoto-san was talking about, and none of Samus's weapons seem to do anything against them. So
run.
Yep. Oh, that slide move is so cool.
Just run away.
Yeah. Yep. It is. Nope. Okay.
Oh, no. Just no.
Yeah. Oh gosh. Missiles don't work either. Oh my gosh.
So, so scary. About this being called Dread. That would be why.
They're very relentless.
Oh, all right. Oh wow. Okay. Did a little reach for me there. That was new.
Oh. Yeah. That one's clearly not well, but it's still quite frightening.
Yeah. I'm glad that it's a bit damaged and can't completely reach to me, but we're going to have to find a different way to tackle that enemy.
You know, this thing is a central unit which controls various areas of the planet. It's sort of a biomechanical computer, kind of an homage to maybe similar units in previous Metroid games. And from this unit, Samus can power up, get a temporary power up for her arm cannon, turn it into the Omega Cannon.
Now you can take on that big robot. Yeah.
In typical 2D Metroid fashion, we've always seen the camera panned around here. And now with the Omega Cannon ability, there's this dynamic camera that you get to see over Samus's shoulder, which is so, so cool.
Yeah, little additions like that really flesh out the classic 2D gameplay without it feeling like it strays too far from what we loved about it.
Just makes it seem really powerful.
Right. Let's see if this works against our Emmy friend here.
It takes a little while to charge up, so
it does.
Don't wait too long.
Okay. Oh, I wanted to make sure I had it. Yep.
I hope you enjoyed that. That's your one shot at it.
Yeah, so it was so powerful that in order to take that Emmy down, we lose the ability of the Omega Cannon, and it goes back to a regular arm cannon.
It was worth it, though.
It was all worth it.
For a moment.
Yeah, I need to go process this.
I also want to point out while you're scrolling your way through all of these different halls that there are so many different ways to play this game. Teresa is amazing with a missile. She's the queen of the missiles, but you can also just shoot your regular arm cannon. You can try and avoid enemies altogether, try and hit them all. Really, it's up to you what kind of Samus you want to be.
Yeah, and as...
Okay.
As Audrey pointed out too.
Yeah, it's just me like just tweeting out stuff.
To do more.
So I apologize for that.
Shooting, but you could also just free aim shoot while you're moving as well.
Well, that's actually cool.
Too, because you need to shoot a lot of different things in this game.
So many paths. Pixelated door.
It's filled with dread.
This is a new entryway.
Yep, these are the entries to the various zones that the Emmy are patrolling. And once you're in there, you need to be on the lookout for those.
Yeah, I think I probably haven't reacted more of this off stream here, but this was an awesome direct. This is a very awesome direct here. Let me mute the sound here so I can check this out. So yeah, I'm gonna mute the sound here so that way I can take a little bit of a break, try to process all this, get back into it. I will be back here in a little bit, little while with some Metroid Prime 2 later on here. I don't know what time I'm gonna be streaming that, but I will let you guys know here in a little while on Twitter at Kyle the Pug. So that way, definitely go check that out as well. So, anyways, I will see you guys a little bit later on tonight, which is more than likely when I'm going to be streaming Metroid Prime 2 here. And yeah, fun direct. I give it a 9 out of 10, and I will see you guys later. #PugBark. Bye!